So I'm just playing with common intermediate language. Basically, I need to install a virtual machine ASAP. Get rid of all this stuff here. Here's the secilc design page. Make a note of that. Have a look at it. Fedora project. I guess I have that in my bookmarks. Fedora project. Get it. Download it. Download now, but view all download methods. See all mirrors. Fedora 19, I guess. 36. And then get something a bit close. Netherlands, something a little bit speedy. These web, or actually 10,000 megabits. Yeah. Just have a look at that though. And releases. Oops, releases 19. Fedora. OS. I guess this should be it. Alright, so let's see if I can install this. I need that test one. It doesn't work. No base. I'm not sure if NoBase still works with Fedora 19. I know it, they wanted to get rid of it for some reason. Two CPUs. And then select the disk. Def S. SDL for open it, forward it, and customize advanced options. That looks good. Finish, and then change some stuff here. Topology pinning, that's okay. Let's the advanced options. I'm going to leave this default. Spy sound channel console. Spiciness. I'm going to set this explicitly to QXL. Apply. Installation. Hopefully, I'm getting a small installation. But anyways, what I'm going to do is I'm going to just play with the common intermediate language. See where it gets me. Basically, what it does compared to the current policy infrastructure is it gets rid of a layer. Basically, in the olden days, oops. Oh, actually, I thought it was a kernel. Oops, but no, it's just the way it works, I guess. But anyways, back in the old days, you basically had yourself the text policy, the policy that you write in the text version. Then you'd use the policy infrastructure to create binary module files, basically files with the period, mod, suffix, and then that would be packaged into policy packages, files with the period PP suffix. And then you'd use those files basically to link them all together into a policy database. I guess I call them a policy, one policy file. But basically now it's that middle layer, that PP and period mod layer is removed that phase. So it's basically just what you get is readable policy, and that's gets compiled directly into the main policy file. Text mode. Installation source, blah blah blah. Oh, not this stuff. Install destination, I guess. Please make your choice. Q to quit, C to continue, R to refresh. So, three, I guess. Let's just start with two. Time zone, Europe. And then Amsterdam. And then three. With IO block device. I guess one. This selected, blah blah blah, make the choice, keep quit, keep the thing, R to refresh. Use all space, that's cool. Partition scheme options, I'll just stick with the defaults, LVM. Alright, that's set up, and I don't want GNOME desktop. Create user. I don't want to create a user. But I want to change 6. Minimum install 12. Continue. And it's processing the software selection. And I need to set the root password. 5. ABC123. ABC123. You have provided a weak password. Would you like to use it anyways? Yes. So I guess we're all set up. We have a mirror, we have a time zone, we have a install partition, we don't have a user, that's fine. We have a software selection, minimum install, and we have a root password set. So I guess we can continue there. So actually, you can no longer specify on the command line the node base. It's just minimal install, and that's just it, I guess. But other than that, the experience is pretty straightforward with the new installer. It's great new design. Although it doesn't provide all the nice options with that you have with the graphical installation, you can't actually manually define your partition setup layout, I guess. Now it's installing a bunch of stuff, procmail actually, cracklib, RPM, what it does, those all look like pretty minimum, although dbus, yeah, dbus is actually a dependency for systemd. So that's kind of suck. Network manager, do I need network manager in a minimum install? Firewall D in a minimum install, ouch. Sendmill still installed, live DRM. I don't think I need that, but I guess. But 236 packages is not that much. It's already done. It's doing the post installation setup tasks. It's probably take a while. So it's not any faster than the Red Hat Enterprise Linux 6 minimum no base install. Installation complete, please return to quit. Press return to quit. Terminated. Yeah. Terminated. Okay. Longer before I reset it. Forgot to enable ACPI, so probably won't be able to do a soft reset. I guess this is it. No, ACPI is not enabled. So that means I'm going to probably have to do a hard boot. Hard reset. Force reset. Force off. Yeah, I don't have a choice. I fucked up. I fucked up. It happens. So we have ourselves a system, it looks like. Root ABC123. Password was set fine, so that's okay. So at least we have ourselves a setup. So yum install GCC. What else do we need? I have here some notes. Lipe SE pulse static LCOV. Oh, actually, Lipe SE pulse static LCOV and flex. Flex and gulp. I'll work from an SSH session from now as soon as possible. Nice. So it's installing some requirements for the common intermediate language compiler, I guess. So basically I'm going to clone two repositories, one for the compiler and one for the reference policy converted to common intermediate language. And then what I'm going to do is try to build it on this Fedora virtual machine, and then basically I'm going to try and replace some of the files that are compiled by the compiler, and then see if I can get it to basically get it in some state of usability, some usable state. Anyway, so I'm here. Let's just IP, but I don't know how that works. IP. Link. Would be nice if I got myself an IP returned. Options, so that doesn't freaking work. And there's no manual pages installed, I guess. Oh, it actually is. So, any examples? Probably not. Nope. So let's get the same stupid options object command. Okay, so IP statistics object link. Why can't I just get myself ETH 0? That doesn't work. I just want to see a fucking IP address. Is that too much asked? I'll just use the good old ifconfig. Oh, that's not installed. Shit. Alright, then good old Google. IP to list IP address. Command. I'll just add Linux in there so that I don't get those stupid. That takes too long. So, can I have some examples in there? IP link show. IP link show. Net stats. No, I'm just getting some IPv6 address, or I guess. Please, varlib network manager DAC client. So ls varlib network manager. stupid camel case. That was one huge mistake. Okay, so I have a fixed address of 192.168.122.246. 122.246. One, two, two, four, six. Yep. A, B, C, 1, 2, 3. You name. R. This is Fedora 19. Yeah. Update. Make sure I'm updating. Delta RPM. Just taking care of the basics. I can't believe that I can't actually get the IP address. Doesn't anyone have a... IP address show? IP address show. All right. So that, I'm not very familiar with the IP commands, but that's the future, I guess, this command. But anyways, IP address show, it's very intuitive, but I'm not accustomed to intuitive commands, so. But that's pretty cool. So yeah, the IP address is returned here. All right, so that's a nice website. Has some nice info. Okay, it's installed. So let's just boot this mother. I'll just do that from the console. Reboot now. Huh? Kidding me? That's fast. That's blazing. I'll just log in here again. You name. That's blazing fast. So yeah, did I install the prerequisites? No, I think. I actually did, didn't I? So let's just try and clone those repositories. So basically, I had this email where there are some links of the stuff that I need. That reboot was really blazing fast. PWD, where am I? I'm in root, LSLC, to see what stuff is in there. Nothing, that's great. Let's see if I can clone this stuff. And now it doesn't ask for a password. I previously tried this in Enterprise Linux 6.4 and it basically asked for a root password when I cloned that stuff. Alright, so cd secilc is the repository for this one. No, I'll just make and it'll fail. You see here it, oh it actually, yeah it, it didn't fail at all. Nice. work straight out of the box. And then basically there's some information about how to compile the policy. So build ref policy. You should do that from the top there. And then it'll basically build a file context file and a policy X file. See, here it is, file context and policy X. And we should be able to somehow use that, I guess, hopefully. So first let's just cp etc se linux to etc se linux. I'll back up or ori and it's recursive ls aussie etc grab se linux. Right, and then we can basically just mess around with se linux thingy. Now cd etc se linux ls, and then there's a bunch of stuff in here. I'll just change the config nano. Oh, nano is not installed probably. Oh, nano config. Nope. Yeah. They don't want me to use nano. So I'll just use fi. Whatever floats a boat. And then just permissive mode. Let's see if I can get this stuff to work in the first place. So that's that. CD targeted. Context. CD context. LS. CD file context files. So basically we should probably be able to cp root file context. Yeah, as a module b. Let's file context, and this doesn't seem like it works. No. That blows. This didn't work. That's due to that file context bin. I guess. I guess I could try it. Nope, that doesn't work. Why the funk is that? LS. To that stuff here. So let's just try the CP again, and then yeah, and also CP file context too. Should have backed it up though. Probably not gonna work anyways. Nope. That's so weird. Where is it getting that stuff from? Is it getting that stuff from? I just don't know what the hell. have a feeling that it's again going to fail, and that's so weird. I think that's due to because it's getting that stuff from still failing. That is the weird. Okay, so let's just go ahead and do something else. So MV policy 29 policy 29 ORI and then CP root policy 29 and then CD contacts CD files. Let me try that again. It's not gonna happen. This is not going to happen. I think it can't actually parse it or something. So let's just Seems to work. Nope, this seems to not work. It does all that. I'm just used to nano. I could use V5, but alright, so these are symlinks, aren't they? Yeah, it sets, we set some symlinks. Okay, so that seems to at least work to some degree. So CD. Here, so that means that we have a new policy loaded. That's cool because the login D thingy. Let's see where this gets us. It's gonna probably be very nasty. kernel t. Kernel t, kernel t. Only UDEF is transitioning properly. So yeah, there's a lot of stuff to be fixed. Let's just have a look. Less. So well, the first thing we need to do is basically take care of user life system systemd. So let's just ls all z that. She's live d. So this should probably be init underscore exec underscore d. So, and then by doing that, that should probably get us somewhere. So basically, how should we go about that? So basically, make there my policy. Make there my policy. CD my policy. And then basically nano my init. Well, I'll just touch it. Actually, I'll just nano it because I'm going to use the other. So basically, I'm going to just have a look at how that stuff works. So there's no policy module declarations as far as I can see. It's just file context or just stuff like this. That's just weird. I have to get used to this stuff. There's no file context specs in here either. Can't see any. So let's have a look at another module. Really takes a different way of thinking, I guess. So go. The policy modules get larger though. So let's just use this one here. Okay. Paste that in. And then in it. Go to init. See, I should probably just should have used that. Falcon has been on C, has been this one, I guess. And then the path is user life systemd systemd. Let's just see. Then cd secilc, or actually cd ls cd sil policy. And you can probably, let's just have a look at just that's okay, that's fine. So what I can basically do is cd my init. My policy, cd my policy. And then create a file nano listing. then just my policy, and then it's what's called my init, I guess. My init. I should probably take care of that. And just try that. No, this is not going to do it, I think. Sure. Guess we'll just have to see if it works. CD. Seal policy. It takes a little bit getting used to. But it's nice. Grep isystemd file. It's in the, oh, I guess that was added already. Okay, so let's just do that. So cd etc as in Linux targeted context files and then cp file root file. text. Yes, and then restore conf v. Let's see if it applies, and I know where it's looking. Yeah, it's there. It's so there. It's looking. So well, let's do that as well. All right. So now it should basically restore gone. I already did that though. And the policy is still the same, so I don't need to replace that. So let's just reboot, I guess. So weird. And now we have something. So we have, that's basically how it works. So that's pretty neat. That's pretty neat. So we did the transition from kernel t to inner t by just basically creating a text file and just compiling it in. So that's just very neat. That a very easy way to do that. Now basically, let's see if we can get it to transition to init, to a SSH at least. That would be a good idea, I guess. And then hopefully maybe I also probably need getting a little bit hot in here. The sun is shining. Thank you. So yeah, cd root, we need to take care of cd map policy of a transition. So we look that init, yeah, actually init right, and just see if we can deal with that. So there's an init. Init system domain. Macro init range daemon domain. Let's just paste this in first before I lose my mind. Nano my init. Actually, yeah. This is not right. I should name my screencast so that I can actually find it. I don't know which freaking screencast it is.
So yeah, I was looking at some website at Turkey as usual, and then I saw the people have built a package here.
Alright, so I'm going to quit this for now. I'm going to explain the more pressing stuff first. So I'll play with this later.